FreedomMunitions.com, your online ammunition destination, presents The High Road with Keith Warren.
We hunt for different reasons, but it's more than just the kill.
First off, I'm grateful to be an American, to live in a country that still has country like this.
It's about the experience, freedom, passion, and adventure. I'm Keith Warren, and like you, I live for the hunt.
Hey everybody, I'm Keith Warren, and today on The High Road, we're heading to the finest hunting lodge in North America. And if you watch the show, you already know, that's the Legends Ranch up in Michigan. We'll be tagging along with some ladies as they enjoy some of the finest whitetail deer hunting in the country.
I'm Robert Sergi. I am the ranch director at Legends Ranch in Bitely, Michigan. We are really excited this week to have Keith Buskin and his group of ladies. He bid on this hunt in Safari Club International back in February, where you could bring six ladies, and that's a big passion of ours to see if we can get more of the female hunters out and experiencing the thrill of the hunt.
I'm Keith Buskin, Norman, Oklahoma, SCI member since probably 1999. The fact to offer a ladies hunt for six ladies, I've never seen that before, and I think it's a great plan on their part. I bid on it a couple times, or several times, and ended up buying it. I called Tom Zanolik, one of the other hunters here, or his wife's the hunter, Carol. Colleen and Jim were also along, and they said, we want in on this deal. So we already had two shooters right there. Then Ganella and Kate were at the show, and they signed up right away. Of course, Angie, she was the fifth shooter. We had the sixth shooter signed up multiple times or committed, and lost him as many times. I called Robert one day and I said, you know, this is really getting to be a lot of work. He called me back and said, no sweat, don't worry about it. He said, Angie can shoot two, or you can shoot one if you want to.
After settling in at Legend's beautiful lodge, the ladies and their guests have a big lunch before Randy gives them a rundown for the week ahead.
One of my spiels on my speech at dinner is I tell them if we see a buck that they would love to shoot on Monday night, they better shoot it on Monday night, because maybe on Tuesday they're going to see it in the back of somebody's truck. When a person comes in and hunts at Legends Ranch, it's a little different type of hunting. You know, we're not going to go out and shoot the first buck we see. What we're doing here at Legends is a management program. We're looking for big, mature animals. And what our job is we are there just to advise you. You know, we're not going to tell you, you have to shoot this certain deer. We're going to go out, look at some animals, and we find one in our class or whatever, you know, we're going to score it up a little bit. And it's up to them if they want to harvest it, or if they want to, you know, continue to hunt and look and see if they can do a little bit better.
Now these ladies are almost ready to hit the woods for the first evening hunt, but first things first. They head to the range to make sure their rifles are dialed in.
My name is Angie Knight, and I came as a guest and a friend of Keith Busking. I was really excited about it because Michigan just happens to be one of my favorite vacation spots in the whole world.
Good.
Dead center.
So you're in good shape.
I grew up hunting with my younger brother. We used to fish and take our dad's 22 out and just kind of pot shot. And then I met Keith Busking.
Okay, he's late. Let's go.
And he invited me about 4 or 5 years ago on a Southern Texas hunt, and I became addicted all over again.
Actually, this week I've got a blind full of people. I've got Angie, and then I've got Keith that are hunting with me. Keith is just accompanying her, and he wants to see her shoot, you know, harvest an animal, and then he'll think about taking one himself. We'll see what happens.
The High Road with Keith Warren is presented by Reconyx, 10X high performance hunting gear, Legendary Arms Works, Sightmark, Supercharged Scent Killer by Wildlife Research Center, 99%, and Tannerite. The High Road will be right back.
Angie and Keith are here on a ladies' hunt at Legends Ranch in mid-November. This is their first sit for the week, and they're about to see what makes Legends Ranch so legendary.
The end of the rut is happening right now, but it's still on a little bit, so we should see some good action. You guys are here for a second-level management whitetail. We're looking for something up to 180 inches, 170, beautiful deer.
All right.
All he's doing is driving his stuff because out of their bucks out there. Look at him. They're pulling off. We get to watch him. Monday night, we got out in the blind, had a good hunt like I was saying earlier. The rut has peaked and is sort of tailing down, but yet there's still some rut activity. So we had seen a lot of deer and just not the right one in that management category. So we're back here at the lodge for the evening. Gonna relax, we have dinner. We've got a fire pit, the gazebo that we sit under and tell stories. Everybody can talk about what happened in their hunt, you know, that night. That makes it really nice. And we'll just get back out there tomorrow morning and see what we can do.
I have a very dear friend, Bonnie Babcock. She was able to come down. It's about a 2-hour drive. I talked to Bonnie about coming out in the blind. She was a little bit hesitant as she thought Keith should be there, but he willingly gave up his spot, being the gentleman that he is.
Okay, have fun.
Deer movement this morning wasn't what we saw last night, but there were some really nice ones that came in, but it was just a little bit too foggy to really be able to tell.
A little foggy.
It was really foggy.
So we're going to come back out again this afternoon and see what shows up.
It's supposed to clear up and be a real nice evening, so I think things will probably happen this evening. We got back in the blind on Tuesday night and deer were moving once again. We were probably there, an hour and a half or so, and we had some bucks messing around out in front of us, nothing that we could harvest. And I looked out the side of the window to the left-hand side and I seen this buck. I had to lean way over and get him in the binoculars, and I thought to myself, this is probably one we're gonna take.
The High Road with Keith Warren is presented by Pulsar, Nemo Arms, Legends Ranch, the entire line of Food Saver, Game Saver vacuum sealing systems, Record Rack deer and elk feed, and freedommunitions.com, your online ammunition destination. The High Road will be right back. Tannerite Binary Reactive Rifle Targets presents viewer feedback.
All right, this one comes to me off of our YouTube channel from a viewer in Oregon. Her name is Mary. She says, my neighbor is letting his little boy shoot guns and I'm scared because he's so young. How old do you think a kid needs to be before they're old enough to shoot a gun responsibly? Mary, I don't think that age has anything to do with how old somebody needs to be before they can shoot a gun responsibly. It all is taught. I think you ought to be happy that your neighbor is actually teaching their child to do it responsibly. You know, we all learn somehow, whether it's tying your shoes or driving a truck or shooting a firearm. And so I think that different people learn at different rates. I've seen 70-year-old men that can't handle a gun as well as some 10-year-old children. So it all really depends, and I encourage everybody, get kids around guns early. Teach them responsible use of firearms. Mary, that's a great question, and thanks for watching on our YouTube channel.
Angie is on her third sit out here at the Legends Ranch, and tonight she's joined by her close friend Bonnie, who drove in to be with her. This evening's deer movement has been great, and they've seen some beautiful deer. The only problem is they're either still too young or outside the Management 2 category that they're looking for. But the group's luck has already started to change, because over at Ganilla Stand, a shooter buck has just shown up. Her guide Sam is ready to film it, and she's not planning to let this opportunity pass her by.
Initially, I thought he was larger than what was expected, and then he said to me, if you want to take him, go ahead. So I decided, all right, I'm going to look at him through my rifle scope just to see what he looks like. And when I looked at him, I thought, oh my gosh, look at him, he's so unusual from the rest of them. And so I said to them, I'm going to go ahead and do it. Sam said, you better hurry up because something's spooking him. And so I, 1, 2, 3.
Good hit. Rack another one, just in case. He's not going to go anywhere.
I aimed and shot him and took him down with one shot. He ran about 100 yards, and then we found him in the grass. And I was so happy, very happy.
Awesome buck.
Look at that.
That is awesome.
He's got character for sure.
Yes, he does.
Meanwhile, back at Angie's stand, they notice some deer coming in right behind them. Their guide, Randy, peeks out to see a shooter walking in, but at the same time, two other bucks are leaving the field, and Randy's worried that they're going to pull the target buck away before they ever get a shot opportunity.
And there was about 5 minutes of extreme anxiety, thinking my buck was going to turn around and follow the other two bucks.
About that time, a doe comes running in and just ran past the blind right into the middle of the food plot. And the buck that I was looking at followed her in, so I told everybody to get ready. This is one I asked Angie, I says, look at this one in the binoculars. I said, this is a shooter. If you like it, it's yours.
Right. That deer doesn't just come in.
Yes, the one with his butt into us.
How do you like him?
Is he a shooter?
Yeah.
I can shoot him.
Yeah, but we gotta let him get broadside.
Right. Bonnie, you got your ears on.
All right, whenever you're ready.
He's down.
He's pretty. Gorgeous.
Nice shot. Right
thank
where you.
You
want it, right?
Thank you. Bonnie, come on. Come on, girlfriend, my Michigan beer, Michigan girlfriend.
There you go.
Yeah. Bonnie grew up in a family of hunters. Her brothers were the ones that hunted, which is typical for our age. And so it was heart-stopping, the excitement that we had. Actually, she was crying because she was just so excited. She said she didn't think it was anything like she expected. It was just a tremendous experience, knowing that both of us love to hunt. And then she got to be there when I made my first whitetail deer kill here in Michigan at Legends Ranch.
As they head back to camp, Angie and Bonnie find out that they're not the only successful hunters of the night, and that few people know how to celebrate like they do at Legends Ranch.
We came back into camp and they have this nice ceremony, and they congratulate you, serve you champagne.
There were four of us women that had our deer that day, and so that was pretty exciting. And we're taking pictures of each other's deer, and we're touching their horns, and we're looking at the different conformation of the racks.
I have never, ever had a group of people celebrate like they do here. I mean, as soon as you drive up with your deer in the back of the truck, everybody comes out, looks at your deer, you get high fives, you get congratulations, everybody toasts a glass of champagne, a great celebration. It just makes you feel great.
Everybody was just so happy and celebrating and congratulating, and like one big family, taking pictures of everybody. It was just a very good feeling.
Yeah, I did have a friend email me today, and he says, champagne and deer hunting really doesn't mix, but it does. Yeah. It's a great way to celebrate at the end of the day.
Since four ladies bagged their bucks on the same night, it leaves only two hunters left, Kate, the youngest of the crew, and Keith. They have two more days to seal the deal and will set out first thing in the morning to try to make it happen.
The High Road with Keith Warren is presented by PyramidAir.com, Liberty Safe, Supercharged Scent Killer by Wildlife Research Center, 99%, Castle Rock Outfitters, and OpticsPlanet.com. The High Road will be right back.
It's Wednesday morning at Legends Ranch as Keith and Kate get ready to hit the woods. They're going to do all they can to make sure they don't go home on Friday empty-handed. Keith is enjoying the chance to keep hunting. The others at the lodge don't seem to mind the extra time to relax and savor the camp life that Legends Ranch has to offer.
Well, Wednesday morning was Keith's turn, and once again the fog was thick, but didn't happen on Wednesday morning or Wednesday evening. Good sets, a lot of deer, but just not the right ones. So Thursday morning, we switched up a little bit. We set a different area. We set what we call the clover field blind, and it was really a slow morning. We set there probably till 8:30, quarter to nine, and it just wasn't happening. So we decided to get on foot and go see if we could run into something. And we'd been on the ground maybe about an hour, 45 minutes or something, and spotted this one buck, and I got him in the binoculars, and it looked like it was one we would take, you know, something that was in our class. So had about 300 yards between us and him, and not a lot of stuff to hide behind. So we were down behind logs, we were crouching, we were crawling, we were keeping trees between us, and I got us up to about 150 yards. You know, at the time we got up to it where we could take the shot, it was unfortunate, but we, you know, just the circumstances, we couldn't get the camera on the deer.
He's up now.
He's down.
Yep.
He's down.
Keith was able to take it, and it worked out well. Really nice buck.
That's what you call teamwork, man.
We got it done.
Concerted effort here. This guy was a little elusive, but Adam happened to spot him, and we got on him, and just sort of stalked as far up as we could, and it was still quite a shot. Keep putting down.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much, guys.
I'm gonna go on.
Thank you, thank you.
Congratulations, sir.
Fantastic adventure the way it all. Thank you.
Everybody was, taking pictures in the parking lot of Keith's deer. All of a sudden, we hear a shot out back. Kate had decided to set the bow down and pick up a rifle because it was the last afternoon, and wasn't too long after, about a half hour after, and she came with a beautiful white tail that she harvested with a rifle. So.
Well, what was funny was when the guys started all honking their horns as we're driving in, and it felt like a parade of celebration that Kate got her deer.
Oh,
what?
The women's hunting group here at Legends Ranch had an immediate camaraderie.
Cheers.
Congratulations.
Because we were laughing the whole time when friends would say, you're going to Michigan on a hunt? I go, yeah, we get to hunt and the men get to observe or stay and go to the spa for the day. And everybody's just laughing about it.
They can't take credit for the females.
That's right.
The team here at Legends Ranch has reached a big milestone this year. We have hosted over 20 female hunters, and we can't be more excited about that.
We pride ourselves in just making this a family atmosphere. We want people to feel so comfortable, let their guard down when they're here, shut their cell phones off, just have a good time, relax.
I liked the guides being a part of the group because it was all like one big family. And the guides weren't separate from us. Everybody was together.
You know, we as clients get to know the staff better. The staff gets to know us better and kind of figure out sometimes we're a bunch of nuts. And it's a great deal.
Robert and Arthur being there also just made it so homey and not like, well, that's the owner and they're going to have their own little corner. They were with everybody. And the staff here is wonderful.
You end up with 15, 16 people around the campfire at night. Everybody is talking and laughing, and somebody's bringing out, you know, coffee or drinks or something, and snacks, and I don't think I've been catered to like that before.
That's right there is what sets us apart. Everybody that we have here on staff at Legends Ranch have the right attitude that we are going to make everybody that comes in here part of our family for the week that we're here.
We love that family atmosphere here. With the ladies this week, we know that some of them are already making plans to come back, and that's exactly what we strive for. And we just look forward to building these bonds and relationships every year. If you're interested in booking a hunt with us at Legends Ranch, please give us a call at 231-745-8000 or visit us at legendsranch.com. Whether you're new to hunting or an experienced hunter, we're excited for you to join us at the ranch.